In this demo, we're going to pick back up with the Person class where we left off and make the next set of changes, which is to add a couple of constructors. Remember that we said by our class coding convention, we would always add at minimum two constructors. One, a default constructor, which just sets some reasonable defaults, and two, a full constructor, which allows us to specifically set all the instance variables as desired. So let's go back here to the section we carved out for constructors, and let's start by adding some placeholders for these two constructors. Pardon me if my typing isn't so good. Okay, so for the full constructor, as always, a constructor is going to be public. The name of the constructor is simply the class, and notice that there's no return type between the public and the person, not even a void. This is intentional for a constructor. And then open and close parentheses, open and closed curly braces, and then inside of this, the guts of our constructor. So let's say we've got one instance variable right now for first name. So let's simply do this. First name equals, and let's say we need some sensible starting default value, but something that's recognizable. So we could do, say, something like this. Just call it unknown. I wouldn't recommend a default value for a string as being an empty string, because that could cause some confusion when you're actually trying to display it. So actually give it some specific name, be it unknown or not specified or TBD or something like that. But when we instantiate an object using this default constructor, what we're doing is we're setting this instance variable's name to this starting value. And then we'll do the same kind of thing with a full constructor. Again, it's public, no void, no return type, person, open close parentheses, open closed curly braces. And now within the parentheses, we're going to add input arguments for each of the instance variables in some logical ordering. Well, right now we've only got one. So let's say our input argument is going to be person first name. And then in a similar fashion, all we're going to do is set our instance variable to that input argument, person first name. So we might do new person and some name inside parentheses. We're just going to transfer this input argument to this instance variable, which is actually this one copy up here. Now, before moving on, let's remind us that having two different constructors of the same name with different input argument lists like this is an example of overloading. We provide two versions, a default, which is a quick and dirty way of setting up a person with no effort required on our part. The designer gets to specify some sensible defaults, and we just take those for what they're worth. And in a full constructor, we specify all the instance variables, and so we get full control over setting up an object. So again, this is an example of overloading. Now, one other thing to point out here is that this is a little clumsy to me, because we've got two different names referring to the same fundamental piece of data, person first name and first name. It would be nicer if we could do something like this and return to first name, or rather use the same name for each variable, but this is ambiguous. So we need some way to resolve that. And what Java provides for us is a special keyword called literally this. And this is an object reference that refers to the current object, the this here object. And so what we can do here is we can preface the left-hand side with this.firstname. It actually turns out that all instance variables in a class, their full name is actually this.name of the variable. So by adding this to the left-hand side, we're removing all ambiguity. This left-hand side actually refers to the instance variable, and now the right-hand side is this input argument to the constructor. And so by doing this, we've made it possible to refer to the same piece of information using the same label, which I think is just a lot cleaner and a lot nicer in a piece of code like this. So whenever you're using your constructors in this fashion, always use the this keyword as we're showing here. Okay, so we've made some changes. Let's save this, compile it. And again, we can't run this yet because we don't have a main method yet, but this is all there is to creating constructors. And we can add as many constructor forms as we want to. And if you kind of look ahead a little bit, I think you'll see that it's going to be easy once we've got this starting structure in place to later add on additional instance variables and add additional instance variables to this full constructor. But again, we're starting small, getting something to work. We'll come back around and we'll flesh this out for the entire Person API, one step at a time. Okay, so that's it for constructors for now.